Welcome to my video that is the third and final part of Modern Greek Language Etymology Prefixes. Today we'll be studying together the following prefixes: en, adi, peri, and meta. For those of you joining for the first time, please visit the links below for the first two videos you have missed. We'll be starting with prefix en, that stands for inside. There is fat chance someone renting a house in Greece is not familiar with the word enikio. Enikio is the noun of the verb enikiazo or nikiazo and means the rent. Enimerono next comes from the root word mera, that means day. Keeping up to date through different channels like newspaper, internet, radio, you name it, is what the word enimerono is about. Likewise, enochlo is related to the word ochlos, crowd or mob. When we cause thus disturbance to someone, we annoy him or her. Any clues about the word enthusiaso? Does it remind you perhaps of the Greek word theos, God? When we have God inside us, we experience a divine entrancement. We feel excitement. Enthusiaso and enthusiasm, respectively, mean to make someone or get ourselves excited about something or someone. I assume antiprefix sounds familiar to you. Let's think of the word antibiotic in English. What does it mean? It means the medicine that fights against the life of invading bacteria in our body. As you most likely have guessed, antibiotic is a Greek loan word. Antibiotiko is its Greek equivalent. Bios in ancient Greek means life. That's how we get biologia, biology. Antiliako is what you will need when you come to Greek paralia, beach. You will need a cream to protect your skin against the sun, ilios. Anyone eating junk food, food bad for your health? In Greek, anything that goes against our health, υγεία, is ανθυγιεινό. Αντιμετωπίζω next is related to μέτωπο, the forehead. When we put a situation or a person in front of our face, we confront it, we face it. It's time now to check at peri prefix. Periodos, period, comes from peri and odos, road or street. Periodos means literally the time frame within which incidents occur in a repetitive way. Perivalon, environment, is what is placed around us. The root word vaso means to put, to place. Think about peripu now. Peripu is a very common word that stands for approximately or about. It is made up of peri, that means around, and pu, that means where. When we are around a place, then we are not exactly there. We are approximately there. That's how we get to the word peripu. Periplokos now comes from the Greek word pleko, that means to knit. Knitting around something makes the thing not any more simple, but complicated. Periploko means complicated. We'll be completing this Common Greek Prefixes presentation video with prefix meta. Meta prefix has two main meanings. The first one is that of a change. Take for instance the word metakomizo. Komizo means in ancient Greek to carry with me. So when I carry with me my belongings from one place to another, when I change houses for example, I relocate, I move. Likewise, metanyono comes from the Greek verb no, that means to understand, to grasp something. When I change what I have in mind, I regret it. This is how we get to the word metanyono. Μεταφράζω next is related to the ancient Greek φράζω, that means to express, to put into words. That's where the word phrase comes from. When we express meaning from one language to another, Then we translate. Μεταφράζω means to translate. Μεταχειρισμένος is the thing that changes hands. Ancient Greek here or modern Greek χέρι mean hand. Μεταχειρισμένο would be a car, for example, that changes hands from one owner to another, a used second-hand car. The second common meaning of μετά prefix is that of after. What does the word μετασεισμός mean? Well, σεισμός is an earthquake, and μετασεισμός is what follows the main earthquake, the aftershock. Μεθαύριο should be an easy guess. The day after tomorrow, αύριο, is μεθαύριο. The word μετέχμιο now comes from μετά and εχμή. Εχμή means the edge, the peak. Altogether, the word μετέχμιο started being used in the military to describe the distance between two camps. It ended up nowadays meaning the point that has exactly the same distance between two things, the verge, or metaphorically speaking, the threshold. I hope you have found this presentation pretty interesting and useful. I would love to listen to your comments or ideas about future videos you would like to see. And remember, by learning to look into words, a new window into Greek language learning opens that holds for you many surprises, not only in Greek, but also very likely in your mother tongue. Enjoy it!